weeks ago, I showed you how you could make your own fogponic system and started some cherry tomato seedlings in a newly built system. Today, I'll be giving you a small update on the progress and a couple of tips, so you won't make the same mistakes as I did.
As you can see, the fog boxes have moved since the last time I showed them to you. They're now in my room at university, where they'll stay for the next couple of months. I placed them right in front of the window, but since they still don't get as much sunlight as they did back at home, I added some mylar foil. This provides the plants with a lot of extra light, and the difference is really noticeable. I just used some tape to stick the mylar to the window and created a little support structure from rolled up newspaper to keep the foil away from the plants. Whenever I want to do something with the plants, for example to check the pH, I can just fold up the mylar and keep it out of my way using a clothes bag. This is a quick and dirty solution since I don't have my usual materials and tools here, but I will soon replace this with something more durable. It's been 3 weeks since my previous video, and during that time I've had some setbacks. As you may have noticed, the strawberries don't look nearly as good as they did 3 weeks ago. That's because the fogger unit of that fog box failed on me, twice. Because I wasn't around to notice this, the roots dried out over a course of 8 to 12 hours. Of course not all the roots dried out, as a big part was still inside the clay pebbles that act as a buffer, but both periods of dehydration caused the plants a lot of stress. You can clearly see the difference between the brown dried out roots and the vital white roots. Most flowers and starting strawberries, as well as some leaves, started to wilt and dry out, so I cut them away. I removed almost all the strawberries, as the plants need all their energy for themselves right now, so I'll let them recover first. The second setback I had was with the tomatoes. Overall, they're doing great. They've been growing really fast and have been developing an enormous root system that dangles all the way down into the nutrient solution. Because they were growing so fast, I hadn't thought of supporting them yet. When I came back after the weekend, I found that one of them had broken off at the stem. Luckily, it still looked viable, so I placed it in a glass of water. Hopefully, it'll grow some new roots so I can put it back inside its net cup. I supported the remaining plants using wood picks and some rope. This should prevent them from falling over. To make things worse, I've also dropped my pH sensor. This sensor contains a very thin glass bulb at the bottom, which immediately broke. I bought a droplet pH kit from an aquarium store to replace it, but this was not accurate enough in the range I needed. Luckily, I still had a better droplet pH kit at home with a much larger range. I'm currently waiting for a new pH sensor to arrive.
That's it for this video. I'm currently working on new videos with some more background information, so check back soon. Or subscribe if you don't want to miss them. In the meantime, you can leave your questions and suggestions in the comments below. Thanks for watching!